Hello there guys, my name is Aaron Chana and welcome to another video. Now this is a football transfer update from Liverpool Football Club, imminent but not yet mathematical Premier League champions of the 2019-2020 season. I'm sure when the season continues, if it continues in the summer as an extended period, I'm sure Liverpool will be crowned champions over that period. They only need a couple of wins, they only need about two wins and that's it. But today's video is all about transfer activity possibly over the summer and the rumoured ins, outs and contract talks going on between Jurgen Klopp and Liverpool Football Club. Now before we get started, please like, comment, subscribe and click the notification bell so you never miss a YouTube video, and let's get into this video. So let's have a look then at the ins first of all. We're going to go straight into this and look at the ins, the rumoured ins of players coming in. That's what ins are. Let's have a look at the first ins. There are three rumoured ins, according to Sky Sports, and of course a recent report from the Liverpool Echo. And first of all, we're going to have a look at Timo Werner. So Werner has told Sky Sports he's still not convinced about joining Liverpool, Man City or Manchester United overstaying at RB Leipzig. So the rumour is there, but it's looking very, very unlikely that he'll leave Leipzig. So I think that if he was to come over to Liverpool, if there was a last minute decision, I think Werner would be a good attacking option. I think that could be in the end of Roberto Firmino, another Brazilian possibly leaving Liverpool, like Philippe Coutinho. And obviously Lucas Leiva, any of you guys remember him, Lucas Leiva? I've seen him play, brilliant. Shout out to Lucas Leiva if you're watching. But no, I think that Timo Werner is probably going to stay at Leipzig, but I think he'd be a good world-class attacking option if he was to leave, basically. Leave Leipzig for Liverpool, and of course the two Manchester's interested, so obviously there's interest from there as well, but I think Werner will most likely stay at Leipzig. I think he's a good world-class player, but I think Leipzig are really building him up here. Moving into our next in, and that is a swoop deal for two Bundesliga players. Liverpool have been linked with a summer transfer swoop, according to the Daily Mirror, published on March 17th. The Werner stuff, by the way, was published on March 9th by Sky Sports. Daily Mirror, 17th of March, reported that the summer swoop would be for Dennis Zakaria from Borussia Mönchengladbach, also interested by Manchester United, and Leon Bailey from Bayern Leverkusen. Of course, someone that Arsenal fans really wanted a couple of years ago, but obviously never came to be. So Leon Bailey, good winger. I think if Sadio, and this actually relies on Sadio Mane, which I'm going to talk about in the out section rumours in a little bit in this video. But with Leon Bailey, I think he's got a good pace, I think he's got floor, he's got good attacking traits. I think that he's a good winger, a good young up-and-coming player, and I think that Leon Bailey would be a good option. Dennis Zakaria, I think he'd be a good CDM. I think if Henderson was to leave the club, or Fabinho was to ever leave the club, or the likes of Wijnaldum or Lallana, and I'll speak about them in a little bit, I think that Dennis Zakaria would be a good midfield option, a good holding midfield option. But of course, with Manchester United potentially interested in Dennis Zakaria, I think it's going to be tough for Mönchengladbach to keep him anyway. But Mönchengladbach, you know, they're fighting in the league, they're fighting for a Champions League place of their own. So I think that they may need Zakaria to hold on to keep that Champions League football running through the club for the next few years if they get there in the Bundesliga as well. So it is very interesting stuff. Now, the last rumoured in, according to these latest reports over the last week or two, is from Malik Thiaw, the 18-year-old with a release clause of £7 million. Now, the Mirror claimed that Reds are keeping tabs on the 18-year-old defender, who has a release clause of £7 million and can also play in defensive midfield. So, again, that could push the Zakaria option to either just Manchester United or staying at Mönchengladbach. Now, the Schalke link means he has inevitably been dubbed the new Joel Matip. Now, that is an interesting one. I think if Joel Matip gets older and gets past his prime years, I think that Malik Thiaw will slot into that position very easily. And I think that I'm sure Jurgen Klopp will make the time for him in the academy. And whoever's in charge of the academy will always do the most work with him. But I think Jurgen Klopp will give him a chance at some point if he was to make an appearance for the first team in the next couple of years if he was to sign in the summer. But I think Malik Thiaw, I've seen clips of him. He's a good young defender, a good up-and-coming young defender. He's got some good traits about him. Obviously, still got a lot to learn. He's a kid, he's 18, he's still got a lot to learn. But as you do as a kid, you've still got to learn these things. But I think he's got possible world-class potential, in my opinion. I think those of you who also seen Malik Thiaw in play, I think you would agree. I think he's got potential. Let's talk about the outs, and there is only one out in rumour talks. Now, we've got two contract talks we're going to talk about in a bit, and that's two players that I've already mentioned, Wijnaldum and Lallana. But the out that's been talked about is Sadio Mane, and this, my friends, is where the Leon Bailey talk comes in. I think Leon Bailey will be a good slot in for Sadio Mane, and the reason why Sadio Mane is on the rumoured out, back on March 14th, the Daily Mirror reported that Mane is Real Madrid's top target this summer. So, of course, just rumours at the minute, but I think if Sadio Mane was to be a top target, that would pave the way for Leon Bailey. But I think that Sadio Mane would, I think he'll slot into any team. He could walk into any top team in the world, any top team. But with Real Madrid having such a good squad already, who do you sell? Who do you sort of tell, you know, with Mane coming in, you know, we're not going to give you much game time because the main games are going to have Mane coming in to play. So who would you take out? So I think it'd be a tough one, but I think Liverpool will... I think the most likely situation, in my opinion, the most 95% situation, in my opinion, is Liverpool will probably keep hold of Mane. Despite him being Real's top target, I think Real won't give up. They're not a club that, you know, gives up. But Liverpool have got a strong hold on Mane, so I think they'll keep hold of him. Now, finally, the two contract talks, and that is Genie Wijnaldum and Adam Lallana. Now, starting off with Jorginho Wijnaldum, or Genie Wijnaldum. Liverpool, according to various news sources on March 16th, Liverpool are in advanced talks to extend Wijnaldum's contract until 2023, including the option of another year on top. Now, with Adam Lallana, by the Athletic news source on March 16th, Lallana could be a one player to be handed a week-by-week contract following the suspension of the football season as a result of the coronavirus outbreak. The FA and FIFA could grant special dispensation of short-term rolling contracts. So, of course, Lallana is out of contract in the summer. If the season is going to extend past the summer, past June, into July, then, of course, you know, you're going to have to sort of discuss these contracts. Willian was the same, and I spoke about Willian in a previous video. He's pledging his loyalty to Chelsea until the end of his deal. Hopefully he gets a new one. You know, I think Lallana will be the same. I think he'll pledge his loyalty to Liverpool. And I think that week-by-week contract will probably happen, in my opinion. With Wijnaldum, I think that contract is deserved because he's been a great player for the last few years at Liverpool. He's been a great asset to Liverpool's midfield. You know, he was the sort of main parts of that comeback in the UEFA Champions League in 2018 against Barcelona in the semi-final. You know, 3-0 down, then 1-4-0 at Anfield. He was the main factor in that turnaround. One of the main factors in that turnaround. It was an overall team performance, but I think Wijnaldum, right place, right time most of the time. So, I think Wijnaldum is a great asset to have at Liverpool, and I think that that contract will be accepted, the rumoured contract. So, there we go. So, that is the rumoured ins and outs. Some of them likely, some of them very unlikely. Werner, in my opinion, very unlikely. Mönchengladbach will probably want to keep hold of Zakaria. Same with Leverkusen and Leon Bailey, especially if Mane doesn't go. Malik Thiaw will be a good young signing for Liverpool. Again, I think Liverpool's season will be focused on youths in terms of transfers. If they do win, I think when they do win the title, not if they win the title, but when they win the title, I think they're going to be focusing on signing youth players just to make their foundations for the next generation a little bit more stronger than they are. They are very strong already. You know, you've seen the youngsters in the FA Cup, but in my opinion, I think that they're going to strengthen that a bit more. And I think with the next Joel Matip, I think that they've got a really strong hold with that defence in the future of next generations. Same with the contract talks. I think Wijnaldum will probably happen. Lallana will probably happen. So I think it's all good on the right track for Liverpool. So thank you very much for watching this video. Please like, comment, subscribe. My name is Aaron Challoner. Goodbye.